Hi all. Bit of a delayed start today. I have two locations actually, and one of them, the internet was bad, so I restarted this broadcast. So welcome to another Chess24 Blitz Banter. So this usually is at 12:30, but a bit delayed today. Okay, I'm gonna go to the challenges that I have, and if you challenged me before, please feel free to challenge me again and I'll put you on as a priority. No, you can re-challenge if you did
here
a challenge.
There we go, E4.
Turn off, let's leave auto commentator as a treat for the game later. Kingscrusher, if you re-challenge me, I'll prioritize you. Okay. So we got an advanced French here. Yeah, it's just a shame, you know, the internet isn't, I haven't got entirely 100% internet just yet at both my locations. It's a dream to have that. One day. Distant dream. Okay, can I play knight a4 here? Yeah, I'm just trying to grab that dark square bishop. Also, by the way, I've got my resolution on this monitor isn't totally great for the board. I really should try resizing the board at some point. Alright, there's knight e4 check, unfortunately. That would have been winning a piece. I'll get rid of that monster knight, try and get hold of the dark squares. You can actually toggle the board size. So yeah, I'm just giving my opponent a handicap when I'm messing around. Okay, let's try and just accept the way things are and continue from here. Okay. No, I can't castle, that's right. I'm doing a Mr. Bean. You know when Mr. Bean messes up, he makes things a lot worse. I'll try and stop doing a Mr. Bean. You know, I don't know if you've ever seen Mr. Bean. But yeah, I mean, I could just make today the day of total disasters. I could do lots of new experiments as well just to compound things. But no, okay. I'll try and keep it as it is. Hey, it doesn't matter about my rating, you know. I know I lost two. I mean, this happens. I mean, ratings is online is measuring internet connection anyway. Performance ratings. Part of the performance is a good internet, especially on bullet. That's half of it, actually, on bullet chess. Also, I think I played unsoundly earlier as well. I think I'm play even worse when I get internet problems. Okay, no, I think I probably was like losing anyway earlier. So okay. It's just a matter of trying to regain some composure, I think. Some composure, if I can manage it. F5. Actually, I'm controlling F8, so could be controlling F. He or she could be controlling F1 soon. I wonder if I get in F5. Now, is this the question? Is this tool dangerous to crash through? I'm hoping it is to crash through with Rook G7 potentially. Actually, the pawns look okay if I can play e6 and f6. So I'm hoping, well, e6 and f6 look good to me here because of the two connected passed pawns. So I've got now mist and fog around these glasses. This is really good today. I mean, I must admit. I don't know. Oh dear. Okay. Anyway, that's a bit less misty at least. Okay. All right, can I take here and take e7? Now, unless I'm getting mated with rook f3, this should be a good idea. King d2. So I should be able to queen without getting mated, I hope. Right, it's not a perpetual check, is it? Let's try not to lose on time. That would be unfortunate. Queen b6 for queen b2. All right, thank you, Chess Check Monk. It's been a relief to be able to play chess with a decent internet connection as well. Thanks. Okay, Don G, to be able to finish a game. Yeah, I had to move location. Yeah. Anyway, enough of that. So, Don G, let's play a French defense. Knight c6. French. You know what? I'm going to play g6, which I should have played against this 2670 recently. This g6 and bishop g7 plan. I think it is relevant in this sort of position because queen h5 is kind of dangerous and it rules out queen h5 in the first place. It puts pressure on e5. Yeah, I played Sarek recently in the knight c6 French. The one Sarek is like 2670. It's quite interesting how I psychologically crumbled. But no, I mean, I think I had better resources, but than the game. It's fascinating from a psychological perspective. Can I play like b5, b4, queen a5? Was it too slow? I was wondering, queen a5. Yeah, I'm wondering what the point of not playing queen a5 is now. Why did I want to do this? Ah, okay. I want to get hacked to death. G5 here for taking in bishop h6 if needed. On h5, I'm just wondering about avoiding hack attack disaster. What desperate options there were just then. Okay. B5. Just to play B4 and Queen A5. Maybe there's Knight D5. Is a concern if I play Bishop D7. Can I just do this? Just to hold on to D5 for a moment without any potential Knight d5, which could be embarrassing, I think. Well, especially with e6 hitting the rook and stuff. So really, I just want to focus my pieces on b2, I think. If I get b2 pressure. Right, now the pressure's off d5, I wonder if I can play this. And actually, that bishop was hanging, yeah. I just noticed now, yeah, the bishop was hanging, yeah. It wasn't just hitting b2, it was hitting f4, yeah. Okay. Right, it's good to be a queen up in general, as a general rule, unless the opponent played a positional queen sack. It's generally good. Good news. Right, thanks, Don. Thanks. All right, let's get the ball rolling here. Spanish. Is it going to be a case of Spanish torture? De Bruyne pairs. Spanish torture for Spanish. De Bruyne pairs. Nice avatar of Kasparov there. Okay, another French. Let's play Tarrasch. Well, I'm on the white side though. Tarrasch. Right. I'll play this for a laugh. Now, can I take here just to dissipate the central pressure? So I'm thinking Queen E2 and C3 and maybe B4, B5 later. This has been some sort of trouble with Knight G4. Can I? Do I worry about that? I wonder. Or do I dare play E5, Knight D7? There's three pieces on E5. I think I'm hoping Rook E1 is sufficient. If I can continue with B4, that might be good. Bishop B2, A3, C4. B4, bishop moves like bishop b2, a3, c4. Know, I think this is a good overprotection point. Overprotection, as in something Nimzowitsch mentioned. One of the more esoteric things that was mentioned by Nimzowitsch. Was this idea that, overprotecting a strong square. I think a lot of the stuff, though, what he's talking about is prophylaxis to make sure your position is secure in different ways. So, like, not having loose pieces, I think, is a simple form of prophylaxis, protecting a strong point. But the basic one is not having loose pieces, really, because that's a prevention measure, before any, like, disasters happen. But having a strong point here, I think, it gives security to position because things, especially a good central point of overprotection, it centralizes the pieces. So in a way, that is a kind of prophylaxis, in a way, more advanced than just say avoiding having loose pieces. But okay, knight e4, b5, c6. Knight e4 does drop the pawn though, right? No, it doesn't. C takes it. Yeah, it's king and queen, not very good here. So in fact, probably b5, c takes and b5 looks crushing actually, but I don't think these are getting out of the way that quickly anyway. So c takes and b5. Okay, I think that's difficult to parry here. I've let him off. I did let him off. Oh well. Yeah. Okay. What about knight d6 before e5 drops? The most popular chess club in London. Oh, I think as far as pub clubs, King's Heads is quite popular. Hendon's pretty popular because Adam Ralph organises tons of stuff. And yeah. All right, so knight e5, and then like d7 and c6, I hope. D7, c6. And c7 looks crushing. C7. I don't know if you guys have ever seen Mr. Bean. I don't know, when there's a sort of a problem, he creates a disaster out of it. Sometimes I do feel like that. I don't know if there's anyone else. you know how to make a disaster out of small problems. But yeah, in general, yeah, if I've got an internet problem other place, just wait hopefully 10 to 15 minutes. I'll just drive to my other place and should be okay. After, except if I start fiddling around and try and create other technical problems just to make everything worse. Okay, so all right, bishop e4 check. All right, no, I'm not laughing at the position, I'm just laughing at myself. I don't know why I've got this. Okay, tendency to do that. I don't know. Okay, so queen, I think queen e6 is dangerous, and then bishop b6 and rook c8. Let's pre-move that. Yeah, I think just basically, you know, it's like prophylaxis is like, you know, locking your car, you know, locking things, you know, just making things secure before like disasters. So you can take all the examples in my system that is cited, you know, blockade, you know, why does that make your position secure before any disasters? Because you're not letting the opponent liberate, you know, the pawns, right? And that could cause, you know, problems, because if the opponent's got dynamic pawn structure, it will support dynamic aggressive pieces. So if you can fix down the opponent's pawn structure, that's a form of prophylaxis. But you can, a very simple example is just not having loose pieces, I think, which is actually in a way more important for like lesser, you know, up and coming, or everyone, actually everyone, not to have loose pieces. I mean, you know. Well, anyway, let's see. Can I do this like reverse King's Gambit with g6? I mean, so, you know, he liked things like blockade and overprotection and stuff. But you know, there's basically more simple ones. King's safety as well. Having good, not moving a pawns around the king. She's just asking for disaster in certain things that we do. We ask for disasters quite often as well. Now this f6 actually, yeah, f6 could be a little bit of a problem actually, unless I'm sacking a knight here or something. Maybe I just accept that position and play bishop e6 and queen d7. What about knight d4? Okay, actually, well, is that we play bishop f5? I thought we'd play f6. Now if I play knight d4, I think my favorite Rowan Atkinson one was when he goes on holiday, and well, he gets a free holiday and he ends up in Cannes Film Festival. I just love the location. I don't know if any of you have ever been there to Cannes, but it's, you know, with the beach and everything and the sun, I just, it's just one of my favorite Mr. Bean films actually, the whole thing. But you know, especially like location, and it's just, it's so funny. So what's that one, what is it called, the one where he goes, you know, the Cannes Film Festival? Has anyone seen that one on stream? Okay, so b5 or rook c8, maybe like b5 here. B5. Loose pieces resonates. Yeah, I think it's the problem with everyone, you know, it's just loose pieces. You've got to always, like, basic form of prophylaxis, yeah, not to have disasters waiting to happen, really. But I mean, that's the point of having an opponent, really, to sort of challenge yourself not to have disasters. And the more resourceful your opponent is, the more likely they'll make any slight weakness you have, they'll turn it into a disaster zone if you're not careful. So I guess, I mean, but anyway, I don't know, you know, it's I'm trying to attack here, sort of, on the queen's side. This is a really strange King's Gambit game. I don't remember. Sorry, this is not even a King's Gambit game, is it? It started off a sort of reverse King's Gambit. Okay. What's going on here now? Okay. Can I? I want this B file, or do I want D5? Maybe D5 is fun, actually, come to think about it. Because I want to control D5. If I played C5, I think I'm relinquishing that D5 square quite a bit. Do I mind him taking that? It's kind of blocking his stuff. Maybe I just want to open up this side of the board. I wonder, like D3, in fact. He'll take her. Oh, there's a check here. If I take her, there's a check there. So, interesting. What about C5 or DC? It's not so easy. Probably I want to try and do this for a laugh. So takes, interesting. Maybe takes here. Let him take here. Maybe take on F4. This is going to be an interesting journey of discovery. If I took here, would I get blown to bits? Because there's always a check when he takes there. It's always a check. It's all a bit too tactical for my liking at the moment. I mean, okay, sometimes I like tactics, but my king's a bit airy. Now, do I lose the rook if I play d4? That's an interesting thing. Would I actually lose the rook? I hope not. Assuming, okay, there's a check there, king h8. I'm hoping this is okay. I mean, there's a check here. Probably rook b8 is interesting, I hope. Mind you, there's a check there, and then this is scary. Okay, what about queen d6? Seems to, at least, you know, prophylaxis holds rook. Holds the rook. It holds e7 for the moment as well. But yeah, what's cooking here? Now, if I go down to the 7th, I'm wondering about B2 and also wondering about my 7th as well. D3 here, bishop D3, bishop D4 liberates my bishop. Do I want to do that? Interesting. Maybe. Because there's no bishop c2. Oh, there is. Rook c2, rook d4, yeah. Rook b2, he's got c1. I'm sometimes thinking opposite colored bishops, you want to sack a pawn sometimes for the attack. Alright, here, trying to get the both rooks working together. Maybe d2 isn't too terrible. Yeah, no, actually it was. Oh, okay. Ah, great. Try and get some sort of compensation for the pawn with bishop a3. But he hasn't got much time here. He needs to speed up. Unless I've just been disconnected again. this looks like a big time decisive game, actually, I'm afraid. Okay, if I put my bishop over here. There's a back row mate on a1 there. If not bishop d1, it's like mate here, isn't it? Okay, yeah, the opposite color bishop. Thanks. Yeah, lucky there. The opposite color bishop is kind of dangerous for both sides. Kramnik student, hi there. Now, you're good at the King's engine, but you've given me white, so thanks. Because we had such a dangerous King's engine game last time. Unless I do a surprise against you, like play a different opening, like not the King's engine, for example, something else. Yeah, but you switch colors on me. Yes. I'm sorry. I'm winning a piece here. You should have been awake there for that e5. Yeah, I obviously put you to sleep with my opening choice, the coiled spring kind of. Sorry. King's engine attack. Oh god, I feel like offering you a rematch, man. Oh god, do you want a rematch? I might annoy everyone else in the queue, so maybe we can play another game in this session. but help, thanks for helping me restore my rating anyway, because I lost a couple on disconnect earlier, which I probably was losing anyway, but even so, okay, thanks for that. But yeah, we should have a rematch in this session if you want, because that was too short. It was anything below 20 moves. I think, what if the general policy, you can have a rematch if you did manage to lose in less than 20 moves by some weird accident. Not enough prophylaxis, you see. This is what happens. we had a fantastic game last week. I think it was game of the session last week, Kramnik student, I would say, as mentioned. Game of the session last week. Can I do this? Because knight e5, knight e5, I'm on the bishop, right? So can I play knight f4? Okay, let's see. Oh, well, loose piece, you see, it's a disaster, the loose piece here. Or is it? I'm hoping it is, because unless there's some, yeah, I'm not sure about this. I'm not sure about this. Yeah, I'm not sure about this. You guys feel sorry for me today. You want to create some miniatures now. You guys are giving me miniatures because of my Mr. Beanishness today or something. Yeah, thanks. Okay, Chessie, let's play. So what is a miniature? Is it like 20 moves or 25? Does anyone know categorically? If a game is less than 24 moves, or is it 25 moves? Does that count as a miniature? I think it might be less than 20. I don't know 100% actually. That's why I'm asking. Does anyone know? There's a special offer today. If you have a miniature, you're entitled to one free rematch game. Special offer expires at the end of this session. Great deal today. Okay. The good thing about this position is the dark square play, I think. I've got this dark square bishop without a counterpart, and I love that, this position. Just, it's so cozy to me. The funny thing is, I thought this was just bullet, but actually, I think it's dangerous on any time control, this sort of position. As long as there's no bad bishop, I think this is a good sign for any time control. To have a great dark square bishop without a counterpart and weak dark squares to hit. Active rook here is very, makes this a souped up, very aggressive opening, actually, I believe. This is a very aggressive position, surely. Without too many downsides, I think. I can cheekily do this, threatening mate. Is it worth it? I can wait for knight f3 and then play it. Knight f3 hg. Knight takes, rook takes his mate. That does bypass it on things, unfortunately. Can I play this? So again, knight f3. Actually, there's queen g3 there. Queen g3, there's queen f4, you know. So hg, knight takes, rook takes his mate, as far as I can see, because of that fantastic bishop. And as far as I can see, queen g3 doesn't help f4, so I'll try this. The other thing is knight takes, I think I just take here. This is the knight's tango system, but I think it's called something else as well. Where you sort of tango the knight to, you know, over here. I do wonder, can I play bishop g4 if white's not doing anything in particular? If I can play bishop g4 and just take there, take on h2. Now he is threatening this because of bishop h3. I mean, it's a good resource, bishop h3. I guess I should move my queen. Maybe to f4, threatening Rook h4. Pressure's still on, I think, after queen f4. I don't want to lose g3 in a hurry. It's a nice attacking little pawn. Well, rook takes. Thanks, Jesse, thanks. I feel quite comfortable in that opening. I have to say, I'm comfortable in that tango. Karim Reed. Try Meroxy bind here. Because one of my recent videos on the channel was about using pawn structure to sort of constrict the opponent, even if you're doing an attack. Well, hopefully while liberating your own pieces ideally as well. I think it's an interesting idea anyway for how you conduct, how one can conduct a kind of positionally based attack here. So the bind on d5 isn't so easy to play in practice because there's all sorts of things you have to look after. Like knight b4 could be a pain. I've ruled out knight e5 at least. I wonder if I can do this without getting mashed. but the ruling out of knight e5 is interesting because usually that c4 is a big problem. If you try and set up Meroxy bind, c4 is a big, big problem pawn. Like here, yes, still a problem pawn. So can I play e5, get into realms of tactics, my bishop's loose. Queen e2. I'll try queen e2 for a laugh. Now queen c7, I'm wondering about knight b5 on queen c7. There's a big price paid for this Meroxy bind. It's the dark squares, isn't it, really? The dark squares, the c4 pawn. There's some it doesn't come free. I wonder e5. Oh, never getting in e5, am I? Is it worth this here maybe. So there's a question about knight d5 as well here. What would that do? It takes. Is it worth it? Give him d4. He could swing a knight into d4. I know f5 weakens e5. Bishop c2, knight c5. There's b4. Oh, there's queen a3 there. Not so clear cut. Still. Let's test it. Hold on a sec. Let's test it. If I can protect c3 in advance, like this, I'll be threatening b4. Prophylaxis in advance. Okay. And now for my next trick, e5. Or b4, maybe b4's fun, and then bishop b3 to hold c4 again. Okay, no, I think that wasn't clever, losing c4 under these circumstances. That was not clever. It's not convincing. It's got queen. Well, maybe I'll play bishop d3. Maybe that knight's all right though for an attack with f5, I hope, to have this knight here and the option of knight f6. But I wonder about f5. F5. There's always like check and stuff. Let's do it anyway. Okay. Oh, I'm threatening knight f6 and queen d4 here. Okay, what is threatened or not? F6? Maybe f6 for queen h6. Kasparov's quote, one of the quotations is, when your house is on fire, don't worry about pawns on the queen side. Is he in danger here or not? Maybe not. Yes, he's got rid of that fawn pawn. What's happening with this knight? Okay. I go for rook f7 and queen h6. It's got here and here and maybe here, but I've got h6 protecting. Is there time? Because he's got rook c3 now, there's no rook f7. Rook d3, rook f8, king g7, queen f6. This might be okay. Might be. It's a bit committal. Rook c3, rook f7, rook d3, rook f8. You can't take that because that's mate. King g7, queen f6, king h6, queen e7. He might have rook h3. Okay. Let's play for rook f3 as an option if rook c3. Actually, I'm on d6 as well. I was on d6. Try and loosen this pawn chain with h5. Also, e5 would be handy. Oh, I should have considered e5 before. Yeah, I think I need to open up the bishop. It's not going to be a game about the end game at this rate. And maybe this rook, just to hold things, h5, rook f6, bishop g6. Unless I'm getting mated on the other side of the board, okay. I'm wondering about hg, rook f7, queen g6, rook g7, that sort of thing, queen e6. I'm hoping there's an attack here if I have an attack here or not, mind you. Alright, let's just move somewhere for a moment. Gonna start moving. Doesn't seem entirely controlled game. In fact, I seem to be pawns down without much compensation. Oh, he's got rook f6 as well to simplify. Rook f6. Oh man, yeah. Okay. It's the clock which saves me. Sorry, it's the clock that saved me. Well played. Oh, that was horrible. I thought I was getting something. I didn't get anything. It's only saved by the clock there. Oh, well, one thing. Okay, Kaz. Let's play this line, which is sort of aggressive, I think. Ed with c4. So it's sort of surprise French defense. Yeah. There's great resources in that game. Queen h8, I mean, as well, that previous game. Great resourceful. It was just a bit slow, that's all, for the 5 minute. If it was increments, that'd be a different story. I'd really be in big trouble. This position, yeah, you don't want to be material down an increment without much compensation, especially. Bishop a3, queen b3, that sort of thing. It looks like there's pressure points. Okay, so there's pressure points because if he moves the rook, queen b3, on f7, I'm on b7. I'm hoping there's good pressure here. So queen b3 and knight g5 could be dangerous as well, let alone b7. Is this rook moving though to e8? Okay, so the question is about this f7. And then, I mean, what if I didn't take this pawn? What if I kind of, well, bishop g6, for example, what if I played knight g5? Would that be interesting? Just play knight g5. Right, the center pawn here is pretty lucrative. So I'm on the bishop and I'm on b7. I could just gobble things like crazy to make it a novel game where I'm actually pawns up rather than several pawns down. That would be interesting experience. Queen takes b7 now, gobbling pawns this game. Okay. Knight e5, maybe for queen f3, gives my queen f3. Bishop d5. Ooh, bishop d5. Ooh, that could be dangerous. That kicks my queen. I've got f1 here. Queen g5, queen f1. If I need it, it's good to know that there's queen f1. I don't have to play g3 necessarily. Queen d3 to g3. Knight f3. Knight f3. I could try knight f3. I know it's like the horrendous double pawns, but there aren't that many pieces to sort of, kill my king after, I hope. After bishop takes f3, the center's fairly stable. If I get back for queen d3, I'll do that probably. Queen d3, any bishop c4, there's queen f5 there, for example. So I expect, I mean, bishop takes, pawn takes, now what? Queen d7. I guess the queen could fianchetto with queen f1 to g2. So maybe it's not so incredibly bad, even on this sort of thing. Queen f1 to g2. Yeah. So I'm sitting on two extra pawns here. Two extra pawns. So, what happens? Predictions in the chat about the Carlsen kayaking, or carjacking, as I call him sometimes. So, guys are predicting Carlsen the win, yeah? Queen d3 protects c3. So even on bishop c4, I just move there because that's shielding c3. So this looks like good news so far. So far, so good. Okay. So far, so good. Give some air to the king. Okay. Now, maybe bishop c5 is better than c1 actually. Because I want to keep my rooks connected. And now what? And now what? Anything constructive to do here? A4. Now I can move my queen here. Start an attack. Okay, yeah. Fangs. Okay. GMR, hello. That's an interesting nickname. So I'll play. Knight c6, I believe, is interesting sometimes. Okay, you have a Chigorin. All right, so it's going into something I didn't really want to go into. Some sort of Nimzo-Indian transposition, maybe. So I'm going to keep this diagonal open for a moment. Can I put the knight over here just to be able to play c5? The knight might be useful there anyway. I wonder if I can play this and c5 later. Or bring the bishop back to d6. So something like, okay, yeah, bishop d6, knight b5 though, but anyway, I'll accept that, I think. I mean, I would like to play a6 here. This is awkward, to say the least. I'm just losing a piece. I'll try knight d4 for bishop e5. So e5, knight d4, it's not particularly great. It's two pawns, I suppose. It's not great, it's not ideal. So e5 looks. Yeah, absolutely this. Yes. It's not getting any better, is it? Try and unpin. It's not clever because knight g5, basically my queen is now in the wrong spot as well. Can I get this for g5 out of interest? Or not? Doesn't look very well. Knight e4, g5. I'm just wondering about trying to avoid this knight sack without the gigantic pin, if I can get to play g5. And can I sort out this bishop at least? So bishop b7 coming up. Bishop b7. Okay, is there some cheapo with this? Some sort of check coming up. Maybe I need to make sure my queen's protected. Just avoid some sort of horrible tactic if I can. Right, get the queens off. Double the pawns and try and grovel. Well, I can keep this bishop on. That knight's going to be pretty nasty. But on the other hand, rook c8, bishop a6 here. So keep the knight on, unless at evil time. Knight u5, king f6. I'm just wondering if I took. Oh, is that. Okay. Is there any chance of bishop c6? Just to evict things. I might be losing another pawn over here. Try and probe for some weaknesses. Any chances of clock here, I think. Obviously, knight down. Mm. was knight d5. And all variations of king g7. Trying to play rook c3 without losing the rook. To knight d5. Didn't manage to notice that. Okay. b5 for c6. Oh, needed that. Thank you. Need a bit of help here to crawl back into the game. Oh, hang on. What have I done? Gotta keep the checks here. It's been a nuisance. Try and go over the draw. Oh, sorry. I did the dirty. I was getting killed the whole game. Oh, that was horrible. Thanks very much. Oh, gold. Sorry. Sorry. Oh, I can only apologize. I'm sorry. Oh, that was horrible. I don't know. That was Chigorin gone wrong. I hate that when that happens. That was... No, I remember I've got something else there. I've recently prepared, which I didn't use. This is early d6 I've been meaning to use. Oh, this early d6 plan. I've used it recently. I forgot to use it here. Ugh, I hate that position. Because it was so passive and forcibly losing a piece. Oh, man. Oh. This is more like it. Oh, f2. I could just take on f2. g4. This is the sort of position I mean to have when I play this, not the other one. I mean to have this sort of position. But yeah. Because I think I've got knight takes and bishop h3. I suppose they're taking here. Doesn't entirely work. Does it? I play g5 here. If a knight takes in g4. Okay, this looks like a interesting position. I take now G4. Knight to F4. My king, yeah, is not entirely safe. I get it. My king's not safe at the moment. Why don't I? All right. Okay. Put it here for a moment. Bishop c6, bishop e4 for queen f5. Or can I risk this? Bishop e6, g3 check there. C6 for D5. What is he doing with that queen there? Can I play D5? Oh, there's knight D6 now. Queen C7. Might not be too terrible. For F3, check later. Now he's got E5. Probably I want to play F3 soon to avoid getting completely hacked to death. Try this for crumbling f5 as a tactical liability, but yeah, I don't like this. I have got bishop b8 though. Hang on a sec, to slow down things, maybe. I don't know. I don't like my king position. Bishop moves back, I take and take here, but do I get mated? That's the thing. Don't really want to get made. There's e5 and queen g6. I'm not careful. Can I not just take? Oh, he's on queen c4, bishop e6. d5, I can take, and queens. I'd rather go for that, actually. Bishop b8 on rook f4. With the queens off, I'm not so worried. F3 here. There's going to be bishop b8 pinning the knight. I thought there was. Rook g8 for rook g2 for rook h2. I think the worst is over here. Don't know about rook e5. Yeah, rook h2 if the rook moves. There's bishop d7. Okay, thanks. Thanks, Simley. That was interesting. Okay, term over. Okay, let's play a King's Engine attack. the King's Engine Attack is something you can play, and it was a favourite actually with Fischer for much of his early career, at least I believe. He played this kind of thing. I suppose whilst simultaneously learning all the razor sharp variations. Oh, this is a 3-minute game. Yeah, I get the impression Fischer was in some sort of incubation period when he was playing the King's Engine Attack with great success, for learning all the theory behind the scenes, and then, but playing quietly earlier in his career. Kind of locked down on this position with knight d5. I know I've just weakened d4. Oh well, you don't get anything for nothing in chess, give and take. Okay, so let's hit this rook. And now what? What am I doing here? Why don't I just take that? C5 is interesting for Queen E5. Vaguely interesting anyway, just trying to get this pawn going. I'm hitting C5. Alright, thanks for the game. Yeah, sorry, it's Blitz. I mean, 3 minutes is even more brutal than 5 minutes for terrible blunders. Let's play King's Engine Attack again, just to get, if you guys want to see a few examples of the King's Engine Attack. So we got a 5 minute here. Let me win. My sentiments exactly. Let me win. Okay, so I'm gonna try King's Engine Attack again, just see what happens here. I'll go back to e4, I think, if the next game is white, just standard e4 business. And so 95. Try and weaken d5 here. If I just give up my dark square bishop just to get a better grip on d5. Yeah. So maybe h5. Just try and puncture all the light squares here. Here, obviously, here and here, this set, this, try and weaken all of them, maybe even g4 if possible. If I can weaken g4 as well and exchange off maybe the light square bishops after, if I get the pawn structure fixed on like this, I can exchange off these guys and hopefully get mighty knights on like either g4, f5 and d5 or that sort of thing. How do I arrange this? I wonder. Queen e2 to f1 for bishop h3. Or I could do this another way, completely different way. I can play g4 and just maneuver a knight into f5. The advantage of that takes, I get the e4 square for this bishop. That might be better. It locks down f5, it locks down this. If I think about the pawn structure as a, well, my recent YouTube video, think about the pawn structure as some sort of straitjacket. So you want, when you attack or anything, if you can think about the pawn structure more as a straitjacket, then you could define a good attack as one which restricts the opponent's pieces and liberates yours. Now here, if I did play this g4, if I did play this plan, I'll be locking hopefully down the bishop on g7. The thing is, if I do it here, he can always take an f5. So if I want, if I'm more serious about this plan, I've got to somehow try and lock down f5. It's not going to happen. He could play for f5 immediately. It's not happening. I might be in a defensive mode here on f5, f3, to be honest. But if he doesn't play f5 next, maybe g4, and it's locked down, as I say, just targeting the bishop on g7. So like g4, f3, knight f1 to g3 to f5. Anytime he takes on f5, I'll get the e4 square. But it might not happen. He's not going to allow g4, probably. All right, so this is more defensive now. F4, g4, I mean, my bishop's killed, actually. I've just locked in my bishop. It's going to have to wriggle around somewhere later if it gets the chance. Alternatively, maybe taking an f4. Yeah, actually activate the rook and an f4, maybe. This is another way, but I'm activating this. That's what I didn't want to do, and it's happening. You've got to look at both sets of pieces, though. Okay, this is improving, but this rook's slightly improved. All right, I'm going to self-immolate this bishop. Okay, I want a knight on e4 just to get rid of this guy, and then I'd sort of get this bishop somewhere later on the light squares. It's not all completely fixed dead. I don't mind an exchange sack here either, actually, because that's his dark squares. If he wants to like play this, I'll welcome it for bishop a1. You know, takes e4. I'm going to take that. I don't mind that, because I would have a lockdown on somewhere. Let's just do this. I want to threaten e5 potentially with the idea of a knight e4 later after that. So my knight needs to be around for e5 as a break. How do I arrange that? How does this knight actually get out? Interesting. Or maybe just e5 straight off the bat for queen d3. This could be good if I get a knight into e4. Knight f1, d2 to e4. I have a pass pawn here. We can light squares. Very good situation on the clock, of course. Knight d2 to e4, but this position, it's interim, it's protecting the pawn. Which is a pain. Okay, what about for the check and take? If I can unpin. All right, so knight e4. Knight c5. This bishop can see the light of day soon. I lost some time there. Okay, thanks to the game. Let me win. Okay, work hard, play hard. Yeah, I did a recent video. I had this 30-minute game on Thursday, and I do happen to have at the moment quite a high ECF rapid play gag, but it's going down rating. But I had a great position. I went over it and I discovered something about how I do attacks, which was interesting, I think, to consider for other attacking positions. Yeah, this idea that you can sort of try and maintain this, you know, virtual bind. If you can try and maintain a virtual bind on the opponent's pieces, any resources you find like that, then the, you know, your attacks might be better and also liberate your pieces at the same time. It's just this idea is, I think, probably quite fundamental. Okay, so Bishop D7, Queen C8. Because the pawn structure, without the pawn structure, I don't think there'd be much strategy in chess, because the pawns are the slowest, they don't move backwards. So whatever you do, if you can respect the pawn structure in whatever you do, I mean, I think that's interesting. Even an attack, even when you attack, I mean, you think the main goal is the king, but if you can like respect the pawn chain and the pieces all the time, that's cool, I think. So B5, I haven't got a bad piece at the moment. I mean, I don't think I've got a bad piece. I'm just trying to, if I can generate some play here. I don't think losing a pawn is such a bad thing here. It's like a Benko gambit with benefits. There's also Bishop G4 is a nasty pin. So there's a few interesting things going on here. I think I do want to open this up. It's a shame I haven't got a knight to recapture for e5 control. Do I worry about d6? Yeah, that's the thing. He's clamping me down. Can I nab this pawn out of interest with knight h5, threatening knight g3? So knight f3, knight h5. And this is like rook h4, there's knight g3 after that. I've got pieces hanging, but I'm going to play bishop f3 after. So maybe this is worth it, because the thing is, I don't like this situation. His evolving situation where he's got both f takes and d6 liberating this guy. Yeah, I mean, if I can distract that with the threat of knight g3. So knight f3, knight h5, threatening knight g3. Oh, he's giving up the exchange here. That's very interesting. And this looks dangerous, this break in the center. I wonder, can I withstand it? I'm wondering, this d6 is, if there's nothing concrete, it might not be so bad. Probably I should castle at some point, probably. Or queen d4, rook b8. Queen d4. So I'm on e4 potentially and h5. Queen e d4, right. Right, let's get the queens off. Or do we want to get the queens off? Probably. Yeah, e5 is going to drop. I could routinely take the queens off or consider knight e4, knight d4, knight c3, knight e4, queen c2. Try and keep things simple. Oh, that's improving his pieces. What? It's I don't know, actually. Now I'm confused. Okay. Queen c5. If queen e5, queen c4, if knight e5, knight e4, what about queen c5? There's almost a check here winning my queen. No, it doesn't work. No, queen e5, queen c4. On knight e5, there's knight e4. Right, what is happening here? He's threatening bishop b5 check. Let's castle. I don't want this nonsense around my king. Yeah, bishop e5 for queen c5 was threatened. Can I not just protect this with knight g4? Well, there's d6 takes. I'm protecting the queen against bishop f7, queen c5. So d6, I can either take with the queen or even the pawn. Right, taking the queens off here. Come on, I'm the exchange up. Should I be worried? Probably. A6, I've just dropped. What about F5? Just try and get my pieces a bit liberated over here. Uh-huh. Try and break this pawn chain. Down. Any knight d5, bishop c4, there's c6. This might be possible to take on d5 soon. Okay. Can I do this? Trying to take on d5. As mentioned, that's also rook d8. Alright, so can I get away with f4 here? This is runaway pawn, surely, on knight e5. I'll just take, I got the runaway pawn. Oh, there's knight c6. Oh, okay. I think I'm cutting the king off. Bishop c4, f2. Oh, wrong. I'm not cutting the king off. Get my king out. I just realized he's got winning passed pawns here, potentially. Gonna try and get rid of them before they win, basically. There's always bishop e8 here. Does it matter? I'll just tie the bishop for a moment. This bishop seems a bit committed to protecting pawns. That's fine. Can I manage this? Is this really the case? I don't believe it. I don't believe this bishop can do it. I want to keep the king cut off, but I don't want this pawn to win. Ahem. Can I not take that? Yes, that was a tough one. Thanks for the game. Well, hard play hard. That was tough to show the exchange up a little bit. Okay, Lizard. Let's try King's Gambit for a bit of fun. Hey there. So I'm not sure I'm pronouncing his name Lizard exactly best. So I'm hoping this position is okay. Can I not play just like g4, g5 potentially? Or is there going to be c6, d5? That's a perennial problem. g4, g5, there's d5 coming up. Okay. Put the bishop on a2. Is there much point of g4, g5 anyway? It's blunted that bishop. Is there any point to it now? Probably actually d4. Oh, that pawn will be pinned now. My queen seems heavily exposed on this d file tied down to c2. So this might not be entirely amusing position to have. So threatening knight b3. Can I pin the guy? For a moment, I dropped b2. That's great. Let's just drop b2 for a laugh. Can I do this? It's good my king's here, because otherwise knight f3 and bishop e3 sometimes. And get this pin here with c3. I mean, a lot of time in chess, it's just tactical chaos. It's nothing to do with respecting the pawn structure. You just got to work out all the variations, the forcing ones and everything. But sometimes if you've got that luxury, maybe of a choice between two or three plans, which might have the objective of attacking something or winning a pawn, if you can respect the pawn structure, I think it's great. So, okay. So yeah, winning this rook. So hitting that thing over there, protecting this guy. C4 coming up, or yeah, this looks pretty much very promising. Now knight e4, yes, does allow actually rook d7 though. So knight e4, rook d7, I'm on f7, I'm on c7. Probably, yeah, this is gonna be well, I'll be playing till probably another 20 minutes because I started late because of the connection problem. Sorry about that. Hopefully next week I'll my other place should be better next week. If it's not, same procedure then as this week. Don't know what's up with BTs. I just, even in this day and age, it doesn't seem that 100% reliable. Internet anyway. So g4, bishop e3. Okay, I just want to just decentralize the knight, but maybe bishop e3, g5. Decentralize this knight. I'm going to take this pawn next. I'll be on f7. I suppose there's knight takes and then knight g3. Maybe I should try and stop that with bishop h2 here, just cutting across this knight here. So knight e4 is no longer on the cards. All right, so knight b2, bishop f7. I'm on h5 knight. I still would like to attack that guy over there. Knight in the room is dim, as they say. Now, can I just let's see. Let's just take here for a moment. Take on a7. I think a6 b4. So it looks as though a6 is going next. Right, so knight moves. Yeah, thanks for the game. There's only one more challenge anyway. Okay. Now Duke Crusher, yeah, we had that connection issue earlier. All right, let me try and play a bit more solidly actually as well, rather than aim to be multiple pieces down for some nebulous attack. I mean, should I try and play a little bit more carefully, even though you're going to provoke me with your Owens defense? You provoked me to go crazy because you play the Owens defense. I'm thinking, you know, how outrageous. But no, I'm gonna treat it with caution here. Okay. I'm wondering, you're tempting me for, unfortunately, you're tempting me for e5, but I think I'm going to try and resist the urge for e5 immediately. I'm going to wait for knight f6. I don't know if there's any great advantage of that. Probably there is. If I played e5 immediately, you see, you could maneuver to f5 quite easily. It will take more time on, you could go back and then, yeah, you could go back to g8, I guess. Do you guys want one fun game after this with the I'll just make a vote on it. Do you want the auto annotator on at this point? We've reached that funny point in the session. Auto annotator for the next game or not? I don't know. I find him he's a great annotator in real life. He's kind of, it's funny to see his electronic version. Myself, I don't know if you guys think that's funny or not. Most of you, I don't know. But let me know, you know. You know, the crazy auto annotator option. We had the last game last week with it. You know, as well as me, I'm not saying that I put him on and not say anything. No, I mean dual commentary. What I mean is dual commentary, but with the auto commentator. Should I put it on for the next one? Technological experiments. Things are going AI recently. I've been talking about that with my brother and friends last night, because you know, like Amazon's Echo. You know, that's like, you know, we're stepping into the territory of HAL, you know, spaceship robot of, you know, 2001 you know, Space Odyssey, and now we've got this auto-annotator, you see. Things are going AI, yeah. Has anyone bought the Echo yet, the Amazon Echo? Because you can say to it, it's like having Siri in your living room, just listening to everything, yeah? And, you know, play this. You know, maybe you can, maybe there'll be an extension to play chess against it or something. You know, Amazon's Echo, you know, that thing. You put it in the living room and it will, you know, you can say, play this music. You know, what's the weather like? You can connect it to your fridge or whatever, garage, whatever. It's like the takeover of the house robot. Okay, so B4, is that possible? Is B4 possible? Oh, you know, I think I'm just losing a pawn if I play B4. I've got that horrible losing a pawn feeling about it. I'm not getting mated with Bishop H2 here, am I? King H1. Okay. Rook C2 for Knight C4. You see, I'm playing a very cautious game here, and I haven't got anything really to show for that caution at all. But at least material is vaguely like equal on the bright side, you know. So Rook E1, Queen B1, B4. Well, can I take here? Is it giving me a slight weakness to play with on B5? I hope. If I protect everything for a moment, even A4 is protected. That's wonderful. That I'm sure theoretically, at least, it looks as though there might be some weaknesses to pick on, just from a theoretical point of view here. Queen B6. I mean, Queen. I can hit B6, which I'll do because there's nothing else to do. I'm maybe threatening Rook C4. If this Rook plunges in, there's Rook C4. Attempt this Rook in. I'll do a naughty, sneaky waiting move, or not. There's always Rook D1, isn't it? What if? Oh. All right, something. I'm not convinced by Rook C4. It would just take here and get two rooks for the queen. I'm not even convinced. And there's no Rook D1, Rook D2. All right, Rook C4, fine. There's no Rook D1. All right, a threat. I'm hitting F7. My first threat of the game. And we've got Queen C2 hitting H7 now. This guy's just too careful. He's not giving me any pawns. It's just not on. It's just not on, this carefulness. In fact, he's nudging me to lose A4. This is just outrageous. Can I play B4 now? An exciting moment of playing B4. Yes, I managed to lose my pawns. But on the other hand, I got some coordination here on B6, finally. To look forward to. I think there's something to actually look forward to in the position. my king looks a bit unsafe. Oh God, what have I done? I don't want him taking on F2. This is scary stuff. I gotta admit, scary stuff. Have I got rook b5 with a5 to follow? Better start moving. Is he taking the queens off? Here, I'm on b6. I hope. Queen e7 is protecting h4. That's a pointless note, little note. D7 looks vulnerable for rook d1. Oh god, I'm getting nowhere. I got absolutely nowhere. As usual, thanks, Duke Crusher. Oh yeah, thanks. Just don't give me any attack. All right, yeah, okay, thanks. I just have to resort to winning on time against you. Sorry. You nearly got me in my king and stuff. It's scary. Oh, blimey. There's no more challenges, otherwise I would put the auto annotator on for the last one. Did someone want to play me from before? Who was that first challenger from ages ago? What should we call it a day? All right, I think used up all the challenges. And maybe see you next week. I'll try and play a bit better next week. No, you guys are really good. You're obviously improving, so obviously all the lessons from before are working. And you're studying my game, maybe. I don't know. It's all working. You're all improving. It's good stuff. Okay, so have a good week, and see you next week. Thanks very much.